Namaste children, you have studied about measurement in motion in your lower classes, that is from 6th, 7th, 8th also. And also you have observed some of the links what I have sent in online classes. So, at a glance...
Stacking, baby!
Now, why are you calling these two terms? are sitting and listening to my lesson, you are in both condition. With respect to child, where you are sitting, when you consider your surroundings and time is passing, your surroundings are not changing. So we can say you are at rest.
For example, area. If you consider area,
volume, density. See, when you are considering area, suppose it is having proper dimension like a square, length square. Area of a square is L square, whereas volume is L cube. Then density is mass by volume. So volume is volume or area depending upon length. Here see LDH. If you are considering volume for a rectangle, so or a cuboid, rectangle area A into B. Volume of a cuboid is LDH. Same way area of a square is L square. Density of the substances is mass by volume. So mass is one fundamental quantity, whereas volume is a derived quantity. So derived quantities are those quantities which will be depending upon either independent quantities or other derived quantities for the measurement. This is one classification of measurement, by measurement the physical quantities. Now coming to the other classification of this physical quantities, based on what I told, description. Based upon the description, the physical quantities again they can be divided into two as scalar and vector. This already we discussed in the lower classes. Once again glance here, scalar quantities are those quantities which will be depending upon only magnitude. What is magnitude? The quantity with the unit is known as magnitude. The magnitude contains two things: the numerical value, that is a number, plus unit. For example, 5 kilometers. Now for description it is given. See, the distance or the length I covered to come to school is 5 kilometers. So how much distance I covered? 5 kilometers. Enough, you have understood. So to reach the school, how many kilometers I have to travel? 5 kilometers. Okay, then my house is at 5, from the school, 5 kilometers. You come to my house, suppose if I have given this word to you, how can you come? Now, suppose from this is the school. If you are considering from school, my house, this 5 kilometers, this 5 kilometers, or this 5 kilometers, or this 5. Or this one, which route you want to know? Otherwise, you cannot come. In this way, you go, my house won't come. In this way, you go, my house won't come. So, what I need to tell along with the magnitude, what I need to tell you along with the magnitude, you need to have the direction also. So, when you are describing about a physical quantity, this is based on description. The classification is based on description. Based on the description, if only magnitude will be describing, completely giving one sense to your mind, that type of physical quantities are called as scalar quantities, whereas some other quantities which need along with the magnitude direction also to make you understand in the description, those are called as vector quantities. This already we have finished in our lower classes. Now coming to your portion. Now the first and foremost definition, the basic fundamental quantity what we have discussed, length. Now to come to your school, from your home, suppose it is 2 kilometers. So to reach the school from your house, where you need to reach school, you need to travel 2 kilometers. So how much length you are covering? 2 kilometers. So here length covered is called as point, it is known as distance. To reach the school, what direction you are taking? Along with the distance covered, length covered, when you are describing about the positions also, that is initial position. What is initial position? House. What is the final position? School. So, there are two rules. Suppose you have to come like this and to school like this. One way, the other way is, this is the straight line, in this way also you need to come. So this is linear. This is another way, in which direction you are coming. So when you are comparing this way, this is long route, this is short route. So the shortest distance covered by a moving object from its initial position to final position is called as displacement. What do you call it as? Displacement. So, both are length covering only. But in this case, how much length covered? Only the magnitude will explain. How much length you are covering to come to school? 2 kilometers. Enough. Complete description. So, distance is a scalar quantity. So, this is the first term which will be explaining whether a body is moving or not. Then, next thing is, from where you are coming, from your starting point, what it is? House. Where is the destination point? Final point, school. So, in two routes you can come. Which route you are following and which is the shortest route, that is known as displacement. So, this is also length covering. But here what you have to mention? The final position and initial position with a particular direction. So it is called as a vector. What we have learned till now? We have learned 4 definitions. One is motion. Then second one is rest. And we also learned that motion and rest are relative terms. Then what we have learned, these two are the relative. Then what we have learned, what are physical quantities? What is physical quantity we learned? And whether these two are coming under physical quantity or not we learned. Then we have learned classification of physical quantities based on 2 things. What are those 2 things? One is basing on measurement, the other one is basing on description. Then, basing on measurement, what we have classified into 2, independent quantities and dependent quantities. Basing on description, what we have done? Scalar quantities and vector quantities. Then what the definitions we have learned? What is mean by distance? And what is displacement? And these terms, what type of classification they will be coming? Both are independent quantities only. Since they both are length covering only, then distance covered is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. These all the terms we have learned today. And my question, what I ask is, motion is absolute. Now that question still, if you won't get, you can answer in the next class also. Now we will discuss about what is distance. Distance can be described only by magnitude. What these two are doing? These are explaining about the motion, the quantity of motion, but motion cannot be directly measured. So distance is simply the length covered by a moving object. Displacement is the shortest distance covered by a body. Have you understood? So, now, if we want moving in a straight line, path. That means this is path, representing the path. So if a body is moving in a straight line path, it is called as linear motion. What do you call linear motion? Suppose basing on the paths, what it is giving? Suppose a body is moving from A to B, then to C. Suppose they say they will be telling, is it a linear path? No. Now what is the distance covered? AB plus BC. The total length, this length plus this length. Suppose it is L plus L, 2L. Suppose this is 5 centimeters. This is also 5 centimeter. Then 5 plus 5 is equals to 10 centimeters. But what is the displacement? So where the what is the distance covered? The total distance covered by a moving object A to C. So AB plus BC, distance covered 5 plus 5. Is this distance covered and this displacement is equal? No. Which direction it is moving? Now what is the shortest distance? Now instead of this, you join A to C. This is the shortest distance covered. This is called as displacement. How can you calculate displacement? We will be learning in the next class. Okay, then you will be using Pythagoras theorem. This is called as, this is, see how it is formed as a triangle. So this is called as AC is called as hypotenuse. Now according to Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. So AC you will be getting under root AB plus BC. Now solve the problem. Now have you understood till this? We will be continuing still about something about distance and displacement in the next class. Then we will proceed to the other definition.